Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm answering another questions from the comments below the videos that we post. It was about time. And how do you show 5-minute intervals or 10-minute intervals and show aggregations at those intervals? How do you do that? Well, stay tuned because I'm going to show you in this video. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, Adam did a video on how do you create a date table, and that's actually where this comment was posted. And I did a video on working with time. You should definitely go watch both of those videos. Particularly if you're following along with this video, you should definitely go watch the one about creating a timetable. Because if you have a date time column and it's actually date and time, you should split those into two columns. You have a date column and a time column, then you create a corresponding date table and a corresponding timetable. And both of those videos will show you how to get those things set up. All right, so on to this video. Mr. Travel Blog said, how can I show summarized value for every 5 minutes? Like, want to display count for every 5 minutes. And I'm thinking, nah, it can't be that difficult in Power BI, so let's make a video. So you guys know what I like to do? Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I found some Chicago crimes data. If you search, you can find the data set to download it. And so I found the Chicago crimes data, and it actually had a column with date and time in it. And I split the date and time into two separate columns, and then I created a relationship between a timetable that I created and a calendar table that I created. Both the calendar and the timetable is created with DAX. If you have the ability, you should not use DAX for these things. You should start in the source. Create your time and your date table in the source. It's an optimal way, and this is what we recommend. Try to get as close to the source as you can. If you don't have access to the source, do it in Power Query. If you don't have access to Power Query, do it in DAX. I'm doing it in DAX here. It makes the model portable. I can easily share this. We don't have to worry about refreshing to some whatever data source I'm using. You can just use the model. So I got my model created here. I'm assuming since we're talking about time, we're going to use a line chart. So how do I set up a line chart that'll show 5 minute buckets? Since we're talking about minute, I'm going to use hour, and I'm also going to drag minute because I want to look for a particular hour on that day. Let's see how many crimes were committed. So now we can see on September 6th, at 5 a.m., we have 13 crimes. And let's see how that breaks down by minute. I'm gonna do it like this and go ahead and drill into that. And then you can see at these different intervals, we had crimes happening at the minute. But what he wants is, he wants those minutes in 5 minute buckets. And I'm like, use DAX to solve all Power BI problems. So I went off and I wrote semi-additive measures. I did all types of stuff. I couldn't quite get it working. And then I was talking to my friend, Shannon Lindsay, and she said, Patrick, well, you already did a video on buckets and binning. And I was like, Shannon, say no more. Thank you so much. So I created this calculated column, and what I did was rather simple. I used a switch statement, and then I came up with my buckets. Again, if you could do this in your source, do it in the source. Don't do it with DAX. For me, like I said, portability. So I'm doing it in DAX. And so you can see right here, I use a switch statement, and I say if the minute is less than 5, make it 0 because it's from the top of the hour to the fourth minute. And then if it's less than 10, make it 5 because it's from 5 minutes to 9 minutes. And then I just continued that. If you wanted 10-minute buckets or 15-minute buckets, whatever type of bucket you want, you can adopt a very similar pattern. Once you've done this, watch this. I'm going to get rid of minute here, and I'm going to drag 5 minute under that guy. Okay? So now, if I choose a different day, let's say September the 7th, you can see at 10 a.m., 30 crimes. And now if I click and drill into this, now you can see every 5 minutes within the hour, there's my buckets. Let's sort this ascending and let's sort this. And now you can see all my 5 minute buckets, and you can see all the crimes that happen within those 5 minute buckets. All right. What do you guys think? Have you done this before? Have you run into this challenge? Mr. Travel Blog, I hope this helped you out. If you have any questions, you have any comments, other ideas, other ways to solve this problem, you know what to do. Let's continue the conversation where? Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. You like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.